Robin Young from Amur Minerals is with me on the line. Good afternoon, Robin. Nice to speak again.
Good afternoon, Andrew. How are you today?
Very good, thanks, Robin. You've announced the completion of your latest drill program today. 82 holes, 20,000 or so metres. Come back with some strong results.
Yes, we have actually completed 20,000 metres of drilling, which is what we had originally planned and budgeted. Because this year we were able to get to an early drilling start and our productivities are higher, we have about 6 to 8 weeks of really good weather remaining, and we're just going to keep the drills turning. There's minimal incremental cost, and this is going to allow us to do some additional infill drilling where we've already drilled and to also target a segment of this large-scale mineral structure that we haven't drilled to this point in time.
So you're pretty confident the Ikenskoe and Kubuk targets, they're in fact one single deposit. Why do you need to do further drilling if you're reasonably confident they're part of the same deposit?
We need physical proof, and the physical proof is what is used to assign what's called a JORC, Joint Ore Reserve Committee Classified Resource Estimate. And by having such an estimate, which includes measured and indicated resources, we can specifically calculate reserves. Now, what's important about reserves is they actually are used in cash flow models and engineering works to allow us to determine profitability of the project. The more reserve and resource that you have available to you, the better you can play with the scheduling. More metal mined early means paying back your loans earlier and represents a higher rate of return, a higher NPV related to the project. So any new resource and reserve that we define that has higher grades than what we've reported in the past adds to the economic potential as well as the life of the mine. So we do have a lot of tonnage lined out in front of us. We believe it's over 1 million tons of nickel now. Every higher quality ton replaces existing lower quality tons that we have.
So more than 1 million tons. You reckon much of that can be transferred to reserves?
Yes. What we have done is taken a very, very hard, focused look at our drill program. We try and not chase mineral that is uneconomic to mine. In other words, when it reaches a certain depth, we know we can't open pit at a profit, or when it has a minimum thickness where it's too small or the grade of the underground is too limited to mine, we will not drill in those areas. And one of the indications that we're setting ourselves up fairly well is that at this point in time, our main estimates of the resources had indicated that over 80% of our resource was classified as measured and indicated. And that's really remarkable for a junior. Generally, in discussions with consulting companies, they are surprised and always pushing people to drill more. At this point in time, with 80%, that would compare back against, say, 40 to 50% measured and indicated, which most companies have. So we're setting ourselves up quite nicely to be able to identify mined reserves that are within coherent mineable blocks, a very important concept.
I'd imagine, depending on your production levels at the time, 1 million tons of nickel, that's going to keep you going for many, many years.
Well, we'll mine it as fast as we can. We have a 15-year mining license at this point in time. We have a 25-year mining license at this time with a 15-year mine planned mine life. So if you take the 1 million tons of nickel resource and divide it by 15, that's exactly what we're targeting at this point in time. There is no reason, in fact, it's included in the Russian law, is that we can extend the license if we have reserve that goes beyond the license life. So that's not a problem. It's just that we want to move as much metal through the plant as swiftly as possible, also enabling us to, as swiftly as possible, repatriate any loaned funds to the financial institutions.
Certainly, and I suppose you're pretty keen to keep this momentum going. You must be getting to that point now where you're switching focus from exploration and drilling and really starting to think seriously about mine planning and the like.
Absolutely. It's a well thought forward question. What we have done is we have been very quietly working in the background on doing open pit and underground mining reserves. We have a hydrological drill rig that has been steadily working on the site this year. We've already completed most of its work, and that's going to allow us to report back the availability of water for the plant and for the 1,000 potential employees, as well as tell us areas where we have to dewater for the open pits and for the underground operations. These are just a limited part of the series of multiple components that will go into a pre-feasibility study that's presently being updated as we speak right now.
Moving into a very pivotal time for Amur Minerals. Robin, nice to speak to you. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you, Andrew.